Good morning, good afternoon, good night to everyone who's watching, and welcome back to another video. So today we have a montage of A-team vehicles. I have had few of them, and recently Greenlight released 6 more of them. So these 3 are from the older series. There's one more car which I am actually missing. I'm missing a Jeep. I think I did not like the Jeep, so I never ordered it. Then I realized, okay, I want to complete the set, so I'm missing the Jeep. These were from a previous set, so this was from the series 19, series 23 and series 25, and the recent release are these cars. So they released a set of 6 special edition, all of them only A team. So we'll take a look at each one of these. And so if you see this is the second release now, and this is the dirty version, so they have some mud and all these things. And I've heard from many people that there are defects in this particular casting. Now here, if you see here close, you see the gap between the wheel arch and the body itself, and the casting itself has only one rivet, that is in the front, and the rear does not have a rivet. We will open this and we will see. Leave your comments down below whether it will fall apart or not. We will open this in the end. Now let's get into this, and we will start from the first release, AMC Vandera, from the series 19. Now here, if you see, this is from the 18 TV series. The parts were all in one piece, no problem here. The detailing is pretty good. Everything is perfectly matched, and I would say this is one of the best castings that have been done from Greenlight, and I am happy to have this. So by everyone knows whose van this is. So this is Mr. T's van, and the wheels are exactly similar to what is there on the real car. So pretty good casting, I would say. If you're an A-team fan, you must have this. TV series fan, at least, you must have one of these. So that is the GMC Vandera. So this might be a little longer video, but I'll try to keep it as short as possible. Now let's move on to this one, the 1967 Chevrolet Impala. So if you see here, it gets a baby blue interior for some reason, and the detailing is pretty good. I don't see any flaws. There is a mismatch wheels on this, so there won't be any close-ups on these. There is no point in doing close-ups, so you will be seeing them just rotating on the turntable. And here the detailing is pretty good. The hood definitely opens, and the rear is also pretty good. Very good model, very good casting, not much defects or quality issues. Glad to have that. This is the Pontiac Lemons. Now here again, the car is pretty well detailed, nothing to complain again. Now yeah, Greenlight, most of them definitely do roll, so pretty good casting. So this is from the series 25, Hollywood series 25. I think this is where the Jeep also was released, or maybe it was 26 or 27, I'm not sure. So this is the Lemons. Looks pretty good. I don't know who drove this again, maybe face itself, I don't know. Someone from the A team must have driven it. So next, these are the 6 cars which have recently come into the market. So we'll take a look at the first one, the 1968 Chevy Caprice Classic. So this is also a pretty good casting. There's no defects by the look of it, and looks pretty good. Now when it comes to Greenlight, I think they have a lot of potential, but just that the price that it comes to in India is a little high, so that's why I rant about Greenlights. But that's for another video. I am working on another video. So let's look at this Caprice itself. Now this is the 1980 Caprice, again very nicely detailed. The wheels look very good, white. And again, I don't know who drove this car. I am pretty sure it was someone from the A-team itself, maybe Face. Most probably it is Face or some other character in the A-team line, because they look like a car that these guys would actually drive. I know that A-team was filmed in 1984, so they do have a lot of these old models in their TV series. The 1981 Dodge Diplomat. Now this looks pretty good in the packaging itself. So by the way, I didn't show the back of the packaging. It's like I was telling, every one has their own tagline, so all the taglines are mentioned here, and all of these came from Cars and All, except for this one. I imported that. Now this is, again, I don't know how they've given all these weird kind of interiors. This is a little dark blue interior and a baby blue body color. Again, lights are inset, very well detailed. No issues as I see it. There is no opening parts in this one. Neither does the Diplomat. What is? Even the Caprice does not get any opening parts. So that is pretty good. So no opening parts, looks pretty well detailed, and nothing to complain here. Again, nice. This is one of the casting that I am looking forward to open. Looks pretty good right in the packaging. Now let's open this. Looks very promising. Hope there's no damages on this because I really liked this when I bought it. So now this, I am pretty sure this was in a episode, I think, where there were these disabled servicemen who were being tortured by the local rowdies, and A-Team came to help, and this was one of the casts that was written by one of the characters in that TV series. And here the rare opens up, so you can see a spare wheel. Oh, the spare wheel that is there in the back seems to have some green color light, clean color paint on it. Maybe this was a wheel for the green machine, I'm not sure. From one of the green machine lines, maybe it was one of those. This gets a tow hook, very nicely detailed. The bonnet does open on this, which I'm not going to try opening because the car itself looks very nice and I don't want that panel gap to show. And very nicely detailed, I would say, nothing to complain here. So this is the 1978 Dodge Monaco, and I remember exactly where this episode is from. The New York City, where two cab companies are fighting against each other, and this was from the cab company that A-Team was supporting, the Lone Star Cabs. I remember this episode very nicely. So here the car itself, if you see, I remember that in the show it was white, maybe it was cream. The show was filmed in the 80s, so picture quality was not that great back then, but they have managed to do a very nice job on this too. Opening hood, and if you see here, I'm just pulling you back. Yes, so the windshield is falling off, a glue should fix that. Very nicely detailed, the hood opens. I will open this because there's a lot of panel gaps, so it is easy to remove. The engine detailing is pretty good. Taxi detailing is well done. Nice green light. The first quality issue that I've come, the 1977 Plymouth Fury. Now this car was the military police car, so mostly you would have seen this running behind the A-Team van. So this was mainly driven by Lynch, so I don't remember the car being this green in the actual TV series. So this car was mainly chasing the A-Team van itself, so Lynch used to ride this car, and I think there was another colonel who later on started chasing the A-Team, so they also were riding the same car. So when I say the same car, the Fury, the year, the model year of the Fury might be different. So this is the 1977 Plymouth Fury, again very nicely detailed. The detailing is pretty good. You can see the number plate also, US Army, and blah blah blah, the number is written. Very nicely detailed and a good car to have. The last one, and something that I was excited but until I saw the arch itself. So let's see if this actually falls apart. I'm going to cut this open and we will open it, see if it falls apart. Okay, still in one piece. So let's take a closer look at the base. I want to see if it's riveted or not. Now as you see, I think that is not riveted. Let's get the other van. So if you see the difference, this one is riveted properly. There is a post here, but not riveted. Now if you want, I'm going to do it. Yes. So they had one job. So every manufacturer has one job, is to rivet their cars, and Greenlight managed to mess that up. Either ways, we are going to take a look at the car itself. I like the weathering effect that has been given on the car. The wheels are dirty, the side paneling is dirty, the windshield is weathered, a lot of dirt on that, and the bonnet also has a lot of dirt. A pretty good model overall. Hopefully they revit their cars next time. I think that is the least a quality control check has to do, is make sure their car is riveted. No complaints except that it was not riveted. Other than that, so we had two quality issues. One major one where they forgot to rivet the car, and the other one where the windshield is falling off. So the windshield falling off, it's a small fix. I can put some glue and fix it. This one I just need to drill the post and it should be fine. So that is all I have for this video, guys. Hopefully you have liked the video, and if there is some model that you remember from an episode, do let me know in the comment section below. I will gladly go back and watch that episode again. And if you're a fan of A-Team, do give me a like. If you're not a fan of A-Team, also do give me a like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, have a great day ahead. Bye.